Hey guys, it's your friend Kat again, and we are wearing these bright blue contact lenses today because we're gonna do a makeup of Gru in honor of Despicable Me 3 that is coming out in theaters, where Gru meets his long lost twin. The minions reappear. If you're new to my channel, or maybe you discovered me from this, but I was one of the people who did one of the scariest minion makeups of all time on YouTube on the internet. Before I went to makeup school, I made this creation. I even did a reaction video to it, so you could go check those out. But I decided to make Gru what he would look like in real life using prosthetics. So let's get started with the wonderful video of turning into Gru. First of all, I'm gonna use a prosthetic of a nose. This is a rubber foam latex prosthetic from Berman's Laboratory, one of my all-time favorite prosthetic companies. Trying this out on my face and adhering it onto my skin with Prozaid. I like to do a thin layer of Prozaid on all the areas, even extending a little out where the prosthetic is going to meet my face and on the inside of the prosthetic appliance as well. Once you have both those layers on, you want to put that prosthetic gently on your face and smooth down with a brand new Q-tip that is perfectly clean to smooth down the edges. You do not want edges that fold into themselves. Once your edges are laid like Beyonce's hair, we're gonna get some liquid latex with a red stipple sponge, which is perfect to manipulate the skin's texture, make the foam prosthetic appliance match to the texture of your natural human skin, blending those edges, making it look like we didn't just slap on a fake nose onto our face, hopefully. And we're even gonna put this Prozaid onto the appliance itself, not just on the edges. This is gonna make a layer that is really sticky so that our paint will adhere onto our prosthetic and not seep into the foam and make it mushy and gross and leave cracks and pores in our prosthetic. It will go down a lot more smoothly. And once it dries, you can use a hairdryer to make this process go a little bit faster. Before getting our makeup primer, I'm using a fancy makeup primer that you don't need to use, but I'm really picky about my primers because my skin is sensitive. Any makeup primer will do, just do not put this on your nose prosthetic that we just put on our face. Next, this step is totally optional, but you want to grab an orange corrector if you have under eye circles that are as dark as the night like mine are. Grabbing a carrot tone concealer and plopping that right on those under eye circles. Blending all of that out with a brush. Any brush will do, maybe even your fingers if they're clean. Then getting the avocado guacamole concealer that is also optional if you have redness or acne on your face. I'm putting that all over the redness, on my cheeks and my chin. Then once all of that is blended into your face, we are getting a disposable makeup sponge that I cut in half. The reason why we're cutting it in half is I am getting this deep tone crossed between an orange and a red prosthetic paint. This is called Pax Paints, made for prosthetics. It has some Prozaid in it to adhere to those prosthetics. And we're doing a layer of like a red magenta tones, a little bit of orange, to have warmth under the skin so that it'll match our natural skin tone better. It's hard to explain, but trust me, doing this extra step helps in the end result. Just want to make sure you don't miss a spot. Get that on top of your nose, under your nose, near the nostrils. Once the carrot looking nose is completely dry, we are going to get a Pax Paint in our skin tone. This is in the color Shibuya by Mel Pax Paint. It matches one of my all-time favorite foundations perfectly. So I'm making sure that it's spread evenly all over that red orange tone paint that we put on our prosthetic. You don't want it to look like you smooth mashed potatoes over yams. You want it to look like an even skin tone. So once that is all blended into your prosthetic, you want to make sure it's completely dry again. So once our nose is painted, it's time to get one of my all-time favorite foundations. You guys know the drill, I always use this. It's my favorite, the CoverGirl Outlast Stay Fabulous 3-in-1 foundation. This is in the color Buff Beige, and it matches this prosthetic paint like perfectly. I don't know what kind of witchcraft that turned out to be, but it works. It looks even. Look at that. I kind of look like the Penguin from Batman. I found this nose prosthetic and I thought this is the closest I'm gonna get to Gru's nose. It's pointy and long enough. Once you have your foundation on, it's time to get some concealer. A very full coverage one at that. I got some Tarte Shape Tape, dotted that around my eyes. Blending it out with the Beauty Blender or whatever beauty sponge you have. on each side and then getting some translucent powder to make sure it sets and doesn't crease. But this concealer is magic, it rarely does that. Once that's set, I'm also setting my laugh lines because I crease like an old woman in the crevices of my face where I smile. Now, boys and girls, it's time to get some rosy cheeks using my Mayron blush and foundation palette. I'm using the blush color with the beauty sponge on my cheeks to give a little rosiness of a natural cheek tone, because he's a man, not a blushing bride of a woman. I'm pretty sure Gru's a man, I don't know. Animations, who knows? Then I'm getting the second lightest peach blush tone and putting that on my eyelids, as weird as that sounds. He has very irritated red eyes from squinting so much. So I'm blending that on my eyelids, and then this is an angled paintbrush I always use for male bushy eyebrows that I got from a craft store. Any paintbrush will do that is angled and large. I'm gonna paint on some bushy eyebrows. This is the Mayron palette that I've been using, just the darker foundation color, just to put a base of eyebrows on. You can use any dip brow product like Benefit, Anastasia, something fancy like that, but any cream paint will actually do. I then switch to a smaller angled brush to do a darker brown cream paint like a dip brow to do the finer details of the hairs of his brows, because Gru has very bushy brows. Very menacing, close together, very long. They look like caterpillars about to go into battle with each other. So once you have the fine details of the hairs to make it look semi-real and not painted on caterpillars on our face, I'm getting that cream blush again and putting it on my bottom lip, just the bottom one, and the darker cream foundation to put in the corners of my mouth to make it droop because he always has this frown. And continuing using that same cream foundation in my laugh lines and making him have eye bags and wrinkles, because Gru is not a strapping young lad. He seems to be older in the movies. What he would look like in real life, I feel like he would have a little bit of eye bags from watching those children and dealing with minions. And then I'm getting my all-time favorite eyeshadow matte palette from Morphe. This is the N35 Neutrals palette. Getting a mix of this terracotta colors and light browns and coloring in the shadows around my eyes where we did that cream paint before of like irritation. And this will make our brow bone and eyebrows protrude more. Like male eyebrows, they usually have larger brow bones. And I'm putting a little bit dusting light brown on my nose as well, just to give it shadow and make it look longer. I am using the lightest brown eyeshadow to do some contour on the side of my face, getting the darker matte brown eyeshadow to blend out the corners of my eyes to give more definition in my eyes, make those blue, baby blue eyes pop. With the stipple blending brush and that light brown, I'm also blending in like a unibrow, some shadow that is also going over the bridge of my nose. You really want to look at reference pictures of Gru for this makeup while you're doing this, of course. Blending the outer corners, and we're also putting some shadow on my laugh lines and on the bottom of my eyelids. Also getting some of that shadow on the top of our forehead, because Gru's forehead is like half the size of a normal human head, if you've never noticed. So I'm doing some shadow above there, and we're gonna do a little trick later to make it look even smaller. So having that brown shadow of line in the middle of our forehead is totally fine, trust me. But as you can see, I just have my hair in a ponytail. If you want to do an authentic Gru makeup, you may want to put a bald cap on. You don't necessarily have to shave your head. But I'm just using the black background for photographs. Now it is time to get our white cream eyeliner. I'm just using the good old trusty NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk and putting that on my waterline to make his eyes look bigger and more animated. Getting a pencil brush with matte brown eyeshadow to do a drop shadow under the whiteness of our eye. Now, I'm getting some alcohol paint that is light brown. This is totally optional, with the orange stipple sponge just to give texture, and even getting a thin brush to do some age marks and age spots on his face. Some freckles, stuff like that, that normal people would have if Gru was a real life human, and even putting more wrinkles on his face, making them look more pronounced and defined. Gru, I feel like, would just have so many wrinkles and crow's feet on his eyes. I'm sorry, Mr. Gru. Getting some more foundation just to blend out the harsh contours on my nose. And after that, now it is time to put on our Gru coat. I'm just getting a black coat that I already had and his signature black and gray striped scarf that I just got off of Amazon. And you wanna make sure you fold the scarf just like Gru, so where it hits his ear and covers his whole neck. Really makes his face look stumpy. Then it's time to get that black paint to make his forehead look very small. But like I said before, you could definitely get a bald cap for this if you're doing a real life makeup for a convention or a cosplay. But we are just doing this for videos and photographs, so I decided to make it look really realistic. More than the bald cap, because it'll really make his head look shorter with the black paint, the subtraction of black with the background. It almost looks like someone chomped Gru's head in half. If you do some mistakes, you could definitely get just a baby wipe and get more foundation. It's all good. Makeup is all about practice. And with that, we are completely done with our Gru makeup in honor of Despicable Me 3. If you have not seen the Despicable Me series with the minions in the movie, I would totally suggest it, especially the first movie. It is very much more heartwarming than I ever expected. I feel like me and this movie have a history and a past when I did my minion makeups. So you can check out those videos down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Also, you can leave a comment down below on what other video ideas you would love to see on my YouTube channel, especially any Christmas ideas. I'm definitely doing a lot of Christmas videos, so I'd love to hear your thoughts. Because I have a lot of stuff brainstorming, it's now time for me to turn back into myself from Gru. And if you do this makeup or any makeup, of course, from my YouTube channel, please post it on Instagram and tag me #catsketch so that I could see it and like it, and I'll probably love it. Because you guys are so talented as well. And of course, all the products I use in this video will be listed down below in the description box. Thank you guys so much for sticking around, hanging out with me today. Subscribe for more videos like this in the future. And I love you all. I'll see you soon. Bye.